Hi folks, I'm in the beautiful Long Abo Valley near the town of Pelaga, deep in the jungles of Borneo. This is some real wild long gun. When I say deep in the jungles of Borneo, what I mean is, I think you can guess how wild this area is. I'm now entering a part of the valley where the hilltops raise hundreds of meters almost vertically left and right of me. The hilltops have been locked in recent years, that's why the water is not completely crystal clear. But this here was just too dangerous and too expensive to exploit. That's what saved most of the forest in this valley. Surrounding valleys have been locked, some selectively, some not so much. But I guess this is the best place because it was just too dangerous to log it. I'm still not too far away from the last local farms, but I'm still pretty sure that this is the wild long gun. I already made a video about wild long gun near Serian. There I find it very high on the mountain top, which was also too expensive to be locked. Here I find it in a deep gorge, which is too expensive to be locked. I don't know how ripe this is. I found one bunch and a couple single fruit on the ground. That's what all the wild logger I've ever seen looks like. The local varieties of cacus, the variety of cacus is definitely derived from this wild logger. The variety of izao looks similar. Cacus is brown, izao is green. The wild stuff I've always seen to be yellow, pale yellow. Cacus also tastes similar to the wild long, and izao tastes different. So I'm not sure if this is the wild ancestor of izao. It certainly has the same bumps. But I'm still looking. Maybe I'll find a different wild longan, which is the ancestor of izao. Izao is the tastiest of all longan varieties, probably in the world. I'll open one of those fruit. Well, looks like a typical longan inside. A tough leather-like shell, an aril enclosing a brownish seed. Taste-wise, this one reminds me of cacus. It tastes of raw green beans. If you buy green beans on the market and then just pull out the seeds, the beans, and eat those, that's the taste. Yeah, smaller than cacus, not very sweet, but still sweet enough for the jungle animals. There is some tangy, similar. Is it similar to mango? No. There is some tanginess which is not that pleasant, which might be a sign either of it not being completely ripe, or maybe just being a more primitive variety while the cacus was selected for its bigger size and better taste. Let's try another one. As I said, I'm not sure if this is ripe. Birds and animals sometimes eat the fruit when they are not completely ripe. They have to eat every day. And they have to be the first. If they wait too long, some other animals will get the fruit. The stench of this also reminds me of conifers. But it's mostly the outer skin. Yes, the almost pine-like tanginess and also bitterness is in the outer skin. The aril is mildly sweet, not that pleasant, but very thin, less than a millimeter. Not much value for body. Also the normal logan or the Matakuching Sarawak they have here, or the cacos, or especially the izao, are much tastier than this. So, not a bad thing to fight in the forest, but the selected varieties are definitely better. Okay, folks, I'm heading deeper into the gorge. I'm sure I'll find tons of wonderful fruit here. Stay tuned for more fruit videos in the jungles of Borneo. And don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.